We're back to the beach this week by sharing stories along our coast.
Stronger hurricanes and sea level rise are causing our beaches to erode away.
But as Fox 46 meteorologist Elisa Raffo reports, one solution is bringing life back to our coast in a way you might not expect.
Yeah, I bet we'll see a good wake.
I'm from that boat.
Yeah. Jana Haddad is a coastal and physical oceanography PhD student at UNC.
Yeah, that was cool.
Studying how waves crash along our coast.
It might look like nothing out there, but there's actually a lot of energy. It doesn't show up until the waves get into shallower water, and then it kind of bursts up.
These waves are kicking up more with stronger hurricanes and higher seas, and you won't believe what's helping ease the pain.
Coastal communities are used to seeing oysters like these fresh on their dinner plates. But now these same coastal communities are finding these oysters fresh in their backyards. Oyster reefs are being used to combat sea level rise and coastal erosion.
Dr. Carter Smith is a marine conservation scientist at Duke, working with coastal management on building climate-resilient shores.
We think we're pretty smart because we've been engineering seawalls for, you know, hundreds, maybe thousands of years. But these organisms have been growing and protecting coastlines for hundreds of thousands and millions of years.
They're called living shorelines, and yes, they're literally living, often made of oyster reefs, salt marshes, mangroves, and coral reefs. It's an alternative to a clunky wall.
So in highly populated areas or in areas where you have pretty deep water, sometimes a wall or an engineered structure is your best option.
But for the most part, when it comes to effectiveness, cost, and durability, natural living shorelines take the win.
But the problem with walls is that they can be really expensive to build. They can be really expensive to maintain. They're often damaged during hurricane events, and they can't adapt on their own to sea level rise over the long term.
As hurricanes intensify and sea levels rise, those violent waves are going to crash against seawalls only once. But when you have these natural living shorelines, those waves are going to crash on these oyster beds and these hard shells once. It's going to crash on those salt marshes another time, and then finally crash on those rocks, easing the pain of those violent waves on our coast each time.
Living shorelines are often similar in price, rarely damaged in storms, and can maintain themselves. Plus, they restore lost habitats, especially for oysters. Oyster populations have depleted by 80% in recent decades.
We started mining just for the oyster shell and making roads and for construction projects. It's also due to people consuming oysters and overfishing them.
Dr. Tony Rodriguez is a coastal geologist at UNC. I learned from him that oysters eat by filtering nutrients out of the water.
Other organisms, its competitors, can't survive half the time out of water, but the oyster can.
Uniquely, they grow in vertical bunches.
They like to be exposed to air about 20 to 40% of the time.
But can also spread out to grow side by side.
Intertidal oysters can grow really rapidly. So they can keep up with any rate of sea level rise, any of the future predictions they can keep up with.
Making them the perfect protector of our coasts.
Folks are really seeing that they're helping protect coastlines from erosion because of the way that the vegetation is able to reduce that energy and therefore reduce the wave heights that are coming onto people's property.
Just a few years ago, it used to take 48 hours to get a permit for a seawall and up to 6 months for a living shoreline.
And I think even in the last 5 years or so, it is exponentially getting easier.
Fish and wildlife agencies have consolidated and expedited that permit process to be equal to that of seawalls.
There are marine contractors now that focus exclusively on building living shorelines and perfecting the living shoreline technique.
Now you can call in someone to put in a living shoreline just like you would a landscaper to put in a bed of shrubs. But while a great natural alternative, one that literally brings life back to our coast.
And there are some locations where maybe people just shouldn't be living in 50 years from now. And even putting a living shoreline along that shoreline isn't going to fully solve that problem.
We need more than just oysters in our toolbox to build a climate-resilient coast. Meteorologist Elisa Raffa, Fox 46.
And Elisa hits the road tomorrow morning. Catch her live from Wrightsville Beach starting at 4 as we continue to take you back to the beach.